sweetest switches, pitches this side of the ditches. Pull up your bridges, I'll be hitting switches on that ass. If I got class, but this is where I'll be giving it up. Cause the fucking me wants to get freaky.
Nobody ever gonna love you.
Now to two boys who were huge back in the 80s as pop duo Bros. Since finding fame and wealth and then losing it all, the brothers Goss are still going strong over in America. One's got a starring role in vampire flick Blade 2 and the other's still making music. Xclusive recently caught up with Matt and Luke for the lowdown on life, love and making a living.
And I see you stranded, yeah.
They were the twins that took the pop world by storm back in the late 80s. High-pitched choir boys squeaking, ripped denims and bottle-top shoes. The Goss brothers drove their fans absolutely bonkers. Yet their fall from fame was almost as meteoric as their rags-to-riches rise, as the boys split up in 1991 amid stories that they had blown away a lot of their cash. But now, a decade on, the once dynamic duo have re-emerged, with Matt spotted sporting a tea-cosy hat a la Badly Drawn Boy, and drummer boy Luke making his Hollywood debut in the high-kicking vampire flick Blade 2.
You and I, we have the same enemy. We want the same thing.
In the film, Luke does battle with Wesley Snipes as the arch-villain of the piece, a role he was dying to get his teeth into.
We did a 45-minute sit-down meeting, just me and the director, no casting people. And then from that place, we then did casting and then studio approval and Wesley approval after 10 weeks of waiting. I finally got the role and I was truly like a kid.
Of course, Luke hopes that his performance, which has been praised by the critics stateside, will finally mean he can dump his Bros baggage in lovely old Blighty.
If someone's bigoted enough to look beyond that, not look beyond that after this performance, then that's their prerogative. The reality is this, I think it's rightfully so, they should remember my past, but my performance should be the thing that is like the litmus test for should we cut this guy some slack or not.
And of course there is one person who is in no doubt that Luke can cut the mustard in the movies.
I'm so proud of him, man. He's like come out of, you know, being a drummer of a pop band into a movie. I mean, it's like he's stuck with it and he's incredibly talented. And he's the love of my life, he's my brother, so I'm obviously proud of him.
Actually, Matt would quite like to follow in the footsteps of those other 80s pop stars, the Kemp brothers, and do a follow-up to the gangster flick, The Craze.
I'd love to do The Craze. Actually, I went to see Reggie in prison, God bless him, but and he said he'd like me to play him, but I mean, I'd like to. Probably the only film I'd ever want to do is the Craze movie, but the Kemp brothers did a brilliant job, so it's probably not going to happen.
No, it's not. And anyway, Matt is still intent on trying to resurrect his musical career in LA.
I just finished recording here, in this studio, about a week ago. So I'm mixing the album now and it should come out late summer. Yeah, so I'm really happy. Best album I've ever made in my life.
Well, we'll just have to see about that, but it might be a while before Matt recaptures his Bros glory days.
It's the end of part one. But in part two, we'll be sipping champagne with the stars at Cartier Polo.